Heaven Hates the Truth by Alexander Tsypkin, translated by Paul Lazarus, read by Nancy Opel.
Sometimes I marvel at life. Here you are, over 50, rich, healthy, smart, super successful, but loneliness can bring you to your knees. You have to keep appearances up, so you do your best not to bitch and moan. However, sometimes you just have to let it all out. Wail! You don't want to scare anybody, so you keep the volume of your life all the way up. And then, one lucky meeting, one conversation, and you feel like even the air has changed. Everything is different. You're happy with every breath you take. Just the sight of her makes you happy. Vadim met Sonia by chance. Well, their cars met. He was on his way home when his Mercedes bumped into her Peugeot. He was distracted and they crashed mid-turn. She wasn't particularly beautiful or young, but she was special. While they were waiting for the police, they started up a conversation, and moments later, he couldn't take his eyes off her. It's funny. When you fall in love at first sight, you think that all your thoughts are being heard by the other person. Sonia, we only met an hour ago, but it seems like I've known you my whole life. Vadim, that's way better than the other way around. Are you reading my mind? No, I'm reading mine. That's why it feels like we see the same therapist. Exactly. She laughed. You always fall in love with the way another person laughs. Always. And Sonia loved you too. So did he. Vadim, music is like sex. It brings up your most buried feelings and reveals our deepest soul. You can't hear it in your mind and turn it off. So later, I'll check if you really love you too or if you lied to me. I even have proof. With or Without You is inked on my shoulder. Vadim loved this song. Sonia had gotten the tattoo for her husband, who was now refusing divorce and wanted full custody of their child, although, as usual, it was all about money. Sonia's soon-to-be ex was towing the traditional line. I can't live without you, but if you leave, I'll destroy you. Sonia didn't say a word about it, but Vadim accidentally overheard a conversation with her wayward husband. In 1 month, Sonia had gotten the divorce and half of all their property. Vadim knew exactly who to call at moments like this. He had one friend who could be counted on to come through on special occasions like this, named Sergei Petrovich. Sergei was always there, though he complained that personal matters were not his forte. Nevertheless, he still agreed to help. Sergei needed Vadim. Not everyone knew how to take ideas and turn them into cash, but Vadim did. This is the story. She's free now. Why do I love her? What kind of a question is that? Love just happens. There's no easy answer. But if you start digging a little deeper, something special can always be found. When he was around Sonia, Vadim wasn't afraid to be a little boy, and wasn't afraid to love with abandon. 6 months later, he proposed, but her response caught him off guard. Can't we just be lovers? Oh, I'm not much of a wife. Also, now I'm a divorcee with my own money. Of course you're a rich man, but you never know. Maybe we should make sure this is real. Sonia knew exactly how to push Vadim's buttons. Eventually, he locked her in the registry office. Literally. 2 hours later, she agreed. For a year, they were ridiculously happy. Countless hours of delightful talks on every subject, and not the slightest bit of awkwardness with silence. Vadim could not believe that he had lived the majority of his life not knowing about mutual and unconditional love. And then his already weak heart beat too hard and gave out. He survived, but was told to have a major operation within a month. The odds were 80 to 20 that he would make it. The night before the surgery, Sonia met with Sergei Petrovich. Sonia, now is a perfect time. You're lucky the contract will end early. Sergei, as in their first meeting, was cheerful, light, and completely merciless. His lifeless eyes revealed nothing. Sonia remembered how he had casually offered her an unusual contract. Marriage with a decent, rich man and 40% of his money when he dies. No one was talking about murder, but Sergei confidently predicted a short conjugal life based on the prognoses of the man's cardiologists. Sonia was promised several million dollars, and she agreed. Right after their first meeting in the same restaurant, she began to study Vadim's life, musical and sexual preferences, favorite books, quotes, and the behavior of his current employees. Sergei provided old cell phone recordings. While she listened, she felt a little sympathy for Vadim. Well, as much as she could. A few of her own past experiences saved Sonia from too much guilt. She began to like the proposition and the cash that came with it. Are you going to kill him? Sergei was reading the menu and answered without looking up. Of course not. We're counting on the surgery. We don't want to rush too much, but everything is going smoothly, so why wait? All the arrangements are in place. You keep 40%, we'll tell you what to do with the rest. You've gotten attached, haven't you? It happens sometimes with the first one. He's a really good guy. I'm not all that surprised. It's strange that no one noticed him before. Waiter, I've decided. I'll have Vitello Tonnato. Sergei was a professional. As they say, cool as a cucumber. Yes, maybe. You're right. He's a good man, and I didn't even notice when I started treating him like a real husband. And also this music. Shit, I didn't even notice it mattered that much. We really are alike, or I play my role well. I love you two so much now. I'll be honest. I can't... Listen, could I... What? Back out of the contract? Stupid question, I know. I'll end up in surgery. You think the worst of us. We don't act like cold-hearted monsters, and that makes you suspicious, especially since it's your first time. We considered that you wouldn't be able to go through with it. Play the role for a bit, but then tell him everything. Maybe he's going to die from this anyway. Less work for us. For over a year, he's been truly happy. Trust me, if you gave him a choice now, he'd fuck with his own anesthesia just to avoid knowing anything and die happily. He's 56. He believes he is loved, really loved. We checked him out in every possible way. Even a guy seated next to him on a plane spoke with him. He trusts you. He sees the whole world in your eyes. Do you know how much I would pay to be in his place, to be successfully tricked like that? And I would die happily living with the illusion. Try to understand. His death won't upset anyone, literally no one, not even his son in London. You don't count. So everyone's going to be happy. And you want to destroy this carefully constructed fairy tale? Why would he want to live after that? For what? He wouldn't need to die. He'd go mad. Or are you thinking you'll just keep quiet and come up with a lie? That's not going to work. Sorry. If you try to walk out on us, we'll tell him ourselves. You'll become the monster. The dead monster, obviously. Sergei was determined. He spoke like a card player going all in. No, really. Tell him everything tomorrow if you want. Be my guest. Not about me, of course. I'm his security blanket. Leave me out of it. But clear your conscience. You've given us enough intel. We'll find a way to get his money with or without you. However, we need you. You're a genius at this. I love it when an extra talented person is in debt to me. Tell me, do you love him just a little bit? A bit, maybe. I treat him like a real husband. I didn't think it would be that hard. Hard? It'll be even harder to tell him the truth. Here's the deal. If you love him even a tiny bit, you're not going to tell him. The ones who love don't like the truth. Love is always telling a lie. If I tell him everything, will you kill him? No. You've got my word. He will come to me looking for protection. To find out who you are working for, we'll have to tell him something. And if you tell him about me, we will eliminate both of you. Oh, but you're a good girl. He wouldn't do that. I understand. Sergei, do you believe in God? Why? Do you think God will tell him the truth? What? Are you afraid that God will point the finger at you? Definitely not. It's all about love in the hereafter, and I told you, those who love never speak the truth. There's no truth in heaven, and given his record, he's going to end up there. The night before the surgery, Sonia sat on the couch in the living room and took her husband's hand. Vadim, I want to talk, ask you a question. Don't be afraid. If I die, I left instructions. You'll be well taken care of. He looked at his wife with the eyes of a little boy, the boy who ran away to his grandma to avoid his angry parents. What are you talking about? Sonia couldn't look into those innocent eyes, and it seemed like her ribs started squeezing her heart. Vadim continued, you know, I used to think it would be nice to die quietly in my sleep. Now, I wouldn't want that. I haven't spent enough time with you yet. We need at least 10 more years. I started thinking how to end my time at peace and happily, and I realized as long as you're by my side and I go before you, it's okay. Sonia's ribs cracked and sliced her heart into pieces. Vadim's face looked like he was dreaming about his next holiday. Vadim, please stop. You're making me cry. Listen, before you ask your question, let me ask you mine. All right. There's nothing more beautiful in the world than the music of you two. Do you feel that way too? It's really important to me. Sonia understood that this was the moment. Either she told the whole truth now, or later it would get even more complicated. It turned out she didn't have the heart for it. She also started doubting that the truth is necessarily a good thing and that you two isn't the best band in the world. Yes, it's true. There's nothing more beautiful. What did you want to ask? Sonia looked at her husband and now understood what Sergei had said about love. It's about you two as well. It's just... What if you lied to me and you've been suffering for a whole year and now it's too late to say that you really love Stevie Wonder? Vadim laughed. Sonia, how did you find out? I love Stevie Wonder. The car crash wasn't an accident. I studied you, learned everything in advance, and bought you two CDs. And also, I'm faking my orgasms. I think I'm doing it pretty well. Vadim stopped smiling for a second. I love you two, and I love being with you. The next day, Vadim didn't wake up from the operation. Sonia was allowed a brief look at him and was told that the autopsy and investigation were already ordered. He looked calm, asleep and smiling. That evening, Sonia drank vodka straight from the bottle. Then she moved to her living room window. 18th floor, flower shop at street level. It'll be beautiful. What a spectacular joke it would be to end her life in a flower shop. But she didn't want to fall on a cactus. That would hurt. Then she stood at the very edge, remembered Vadim's perpetually smiling face, Sergei's impenetrable eyes, thought it over one more time, flashed through all of last year, and took a step. A step back, closed the window, turned on the light, and saw Sergei sitting at the table. Good for you, no jump. You fulfilled my expectations. I just won an excellent bottle of cognac. Now we can give you a big project. Where's your coffee machine? No coffee machine. Finally, Sonia fainted. 15 minutes later, Sergei, who had just poured himself something that looked like coffee, finished his motivational lecture. You need to understand that we needed you to make your own choice, not to tell the truth, and to forgive yourself. Our jobs require complete commitment. No ambivalence and no cheating. Making someone deeply happy isn't the same thing as getting money for dropping your panties. Why didn't you jump? Scared? Yes, I got scared, but that's not the reason I didn't jump. I decided I like the terms. I want to do this for the rest of my life. And, well, so I decided not to jump. He's better off this way. Exactly. That's the most important thing. I knew you would ultimately understand. Personally, I've never made anyone happy in my entire life, and you've already done it. You made Vadim totally happy. It's rare when someone can effortlessly say things that make the air in your lungs freeze. Sergei could do that. Sonia, who was not nearly as in control as Sergei, asked a very childish question. But seriously, what if I had told him everything? What would have happened? The fairy tale would not have ended happily ever after. You would have been dead the same day. I lied to you in the cafe, but I figured out from the very beginning you were not going to tell him the truth when he started asking for reassurance and bringing up you two. You heard everything? Sonia, we deal with serious money and sometimes terrible secrets. We don't take risks. Sorry, no hard feelings, but I need people around me who totally believe in what they're doing. You know, if you had told him everything, that means you're really a cunt. You can't love your own karma more than the happiness of the one who loves you. He's doing well now. 100% better than us. This cruel man talked so easily, as if he were discussing the weather. But you know what he doesn't have up there? Coffee. Want some? Sergei didn't need a lie detector to see that Sonia was finally getting it. His message was successfully reaching her, and his brutal but honest experiment had come to an end. No coffee for me. But what's the new project? Number 23 on the famous list. What list? Best in show. Come on. The Forbes list, of course, billionaires. He became a widower a short while ago, so you have a lot in common. You took care of her, too? Jesus, Sonia, of course not. But the idea is interesting. I'll file it for the future. Car crash again? Not sure yet. Maybe you can meet at the cemetery? Sergei laughed and looked in her eyes. A final test. He was checking to see if she had any sense of humor left. Wordplay and subtext were his favorite entertainments. Sonia chose to smile. Sergei, what kind of music does he like? Stevie Wonder. Jesus! Joking. Pink Floyd, Wish You Were Here, etc. I'll download it. Listen, do you have someone who loves Depeche Mode? Yes, but we're not giving them to you. You'll spare them. Depeche Mode is too important to you, more than money and principles. I know everything about you, but I really don't understand why you like them. And Pink Floyd is good. I'm sure you've heard them. Another Brick in the Wall? Yeah, I've heard their stuff, but I need to get to like them. Can I ask some stupid questions? You can. Do you believe in love? No, I don't. That's why I love my wife. A lot. And does she love you? Ask her after my funeral. I really don't want to know the truth. Let me guess the next question. Yes, we both love the same music. He winked and finished his coffee. Is the interrogation over? Last one. Go ahead. I know we are murderers, but not at all. We just deliver overdoses of happiness. Maybe. But I will ask my question anyway. Will I see Vadim up there? Sergei's face lost all its previous carelessness. He stared hard at Sonia. Finally, a good question, Sonia. It depends on who's up there we're talking about. He will see you, but you won't see him. Fair deal, isn't it?